Okay, so what's the question?
Let me just get it again. Okay, how do you deal with uncertainty, the future, or events that you have zero control over?
Am I going first?
Yeah.
Okay, so uncertainty I feel like is present in every situation that has a future timeline, basically. So any future event is automatically uncertain because it is in the future, and so anything can change now that will affect that situation. So if you're planning to run a 10k, you can be certain that you're training towards running the 10k, but anything can happen between now. Even if you're training, you can still get an injury the night before, for example. And so uncertainty, I feel like, is always associated with the future. So then in terms of having a future event that you know is certain, but that you have no control over, like maybe doing a speech, I think in that situation, when you have the certainty of the event, but maybe there's anxiety around that event, or uncertainty of how you're going to do it, or uncertainty around how many people are going to be watching you, what are people going to think, what are people going to say, that is when you get more anxious, because you don't really have control over the situation, because it's not in your now moment. So I think in terms of dealing with uncertainty, and I think in terms of managing the stress or anxiety around a future event that we have no control over, I think it's important to accept that we can't yet control something that isn't in our present moment. And so it doesn't help to stress over a future event. It doesn't help to stress over the uncertainty of an unknown in the future, because it hasn't yet happened. So all you're actually doing is stressing about an idea. You're not even stressing about something that's real yet. It's not even real. It's not even in your reality yet. You're just thinking about it so much. And because it's uncertain, you can think of a number of different ways that this is going to go. And you can freak out about each one of them. And so you're actually just playing in your mind, because usually
you're running with it.
You run with it. You catastrophize. And then you get to that situation and it's not nearly as bad as you thought it was going to be.
Exactly.
So in terms of dealing with uncertainty, I think staying present. Because that's where your life is actually happening, in the now moment. It's not happening... like, the future isn't happening now. It's still in the future. So you can't control it yet. Only when it's in your now, when that now moment does arrive, only then will you actually have control. So I think focusing on the present and not catastrophizing and focusing too much on the future, because you can't control it.
And like using your example of wanting to run a 10K, like now with COVID, a lot of events were cancelled, like 10k events or marathons were cancelled, and then you need to ask yourself, okay, so I've been practicing for this 10k and now the event is cancelled, so what do I do? I could still do the 10k, just not in the event. Let me just do my 10k here. Or are you just gonna let it bash you down and say, oh well, I trained for nothing, it was all for nothing? It wasn't for nothing. You can still go do the 10k, just not at the event.
That's the thing. I think people again get attached to even
the
idea of the event, and then they're not even motivated to train anymore for the 10k, because they're like, oh well, the event's cancelled.
Or even with training, why do I need to train if I can't even go to the beach now? Hey,
it's like, that's the only reason you're training is to be on the beach.
Yeah.
Exactly. You're not really training to train. You're not training to be healthy.
I just thought of that now.
So how do you deal with uncertainty or a future event that you can't control?
So with uncertainty, like if you use traffic, for example, you go your usual time to work, you hit traffic. That's completely out of your control. You can't control an accident or something that happened on the road. So I feel like trusting that everything happens for a reason, like you were meant to be in traffic for a reason, so that could have been you in the accident, like something could have happened, but you were meant to be held back for a reason. Like I feel like that's a big one, is trusting that it happens for a reason and believing that everything will work out for the best. Like you are meant to be doing everything for a reason.
And everything is in line.
Yeah.
So the things that you learn from that situation, or the thing that is holding you back there, you don't know, because again, we can't tell the future. So even just knowing, for example, that you don't have control over the situation, and accepting that you can't change your predicament, and so you might as well just relax. Like, you're sitting in traffic, you can't control the traffic, and so accepting, okay, I'm gonna be late, or I'm sitting in traffic and there's nothing I can do. And so not sitting in the negativity, not allowing yourself to get upset or worked up, because what's the point?
So really the answer is being present then. Being present with your life now and not stressing about the future or the past.
Being just present. Because this is where your life is happening.
This is where the harmony and happiness is just being present.
But this is where you are, in the present. It's your mind that is in the future or in the past. But again, that's the thing, we get carried away. We don't even realize that we often thinking all the time. And so that's where our attention is, that's where our focus is. And so we've learned that we can't even really be present. Like, we don't even know how to be present. We always must be busy with something. We've lost the art of the now.
Stop focusing on what if and focus on now.
What is?
What is?
Stop focusing on what if and start focusing on what is.
That's beautiful.
I like that.
And that's today's one.